you guys did offensively against Texas. Just how encouraging was that, given that y'all only made six threes?
Well, again, it's the fact that we do want to be able to score on nights when we can't, aren't shooting the three well, but some of that is their game plan. Was obvious that they were going to do what a lot of teams have done to us, really try to take away the perimeter and force us to go inside with it. And over the last couple of weeks, I think the fact that we've put a lot of time on that inside game and to see different guys do it, but certainly the other night to see Olivier play the way he played is really encouraging. And but also, I think our guards did a great job of getting those guys involved, especially, you know, they were trying to mix their defenses, probably more so because they had a little foul trouble and the way our perimeter guys were looking to get the ball inside against the zone and different defenses. But it's encouraging any time that we can get great balance. And just this team, I think we got guys that can score at different levels, and we just got to get consistent.
What jumped out at you that you liked when you watched the tape Saturday night?
Well, one is a really hard-fought game both ways. I mean, both teams weren't giving up a lot on the defensive end, and certainly, and I thought in the second half, it's my fault, certainly. I thought Santi and probably more than anyone got a little fatigued. And then, you know, Marcus Carr didn't play much in the first half, and he came back and was certainly fresh in the second half. And we uncharacteristically gave up some back cuts that we normally don't give up. We don't normally give up as many. They had a couple, and again, you got to give them credit. They were cutting, moving, but we got on some of the switches, things that we've played against all year, we weren't as clean as we needed to be defensively, that we got to get better there. And that certainly have to, again, we have to get better in that. That's just communication, and we can fix that. And our guys, I'm sure, will work at doing it. But overall, you know, the effort getting to the glass, trying to block out, and really playing together is what really jumped out probably as much. I didn't think anybody really tried to force anything. I thought, and we've talked about being connected, not just on the defensive end, but offensively, and we'll get better there, and we've got to get better. But overall, it was a really hard-fought basketball game.
After the game, you said Zakai Zeigler is along with some of the best point guards in the nation. At what point did you see it kind of click for him as making other teammates better within the offense?
Well, it's something that we talked to him about from last year on, really starting to understand what a point guard does. And you know, he's such a team player, and I'm not sure there's a guard in the country that's impacted the game as much as he had, certainly in the month of January. I mean, he has been terrific in every area that you could ask him to be. Zakai is very unselfish. He's a tough, hard-nosed competitor that just he wants to win. And but he has really embraced the fact that he does want to play the game different than he had through the years in terms of, I mean, he can shoot the ball, he can score the ball, but really trying to make his teammates better. And I would say it's not just been this month. I think it's something he's really worked on from the time that we started with this team, knowing that he would needed to do that. And once it starts to click for him, and I think it is, I think he's seeing the court in a whole different way than he ever has. I think his vision, seeing it, and I think it's slowed down for him, seeing all 10 guys on the floor, 9 guys on the floor, and seeing what's going on.
This team played with a different edge the last couple of weeks?
You know, I don't know if it's so much an edge. I do think that the hardest month of the year mentally is probably January, because, you know, you go through your whole fall season and Christmas break comes, and, you know, things are different. Things are different on campus. Their schedules changed. I think their bodies changed, and the fact that, you know, they go from one routine to the next, and then school starts back, and really and truly, I mean, January is a tough month in college basketball for everybody. Just the fact that it's you've played a lot, you've practiced a lot, you've played a lot, and now you get into February, which we know is obviously an important month for everybody. A lot of basketball left to play. I mean, for everybody. But I do think our guys, I would expect, we've got guys that have played a lot of minutes here. They know what it's about, and I do know that they know that we've got to continue to get better. And, you know, we talk about that all the time, about what do we have to do to continue to raise the ceiling and the standard that we want to play with and the standard that we want to be held to, and it's got to come from within. And I think we've got a group of guys that will have embraced it and will continue to embrace it.
two or three things that are going to define whether this team is successful in February or not?
Again, I think ball screen, defense, I'll always start on the defensive end where you've got to be good. You got to be really good in ball screen coverage. You got to be able to guard. You got to win those individual battles, rebounding. And then the fact that now you're looking for consistency, I think role definition becomes probably more important. Well, it's always important, but it becomes probably a little bit clearer. But with that said, knowing there's a lot of basketball left to play, that could still change a little bit too. And then on the offensive end, that we just really know that we've got to be consistent. Got to get certain guys in certain areas of the court where they can be effective, and that's on me, obviously. But I would say to you, one thing for certain, we got to get better at transition defense. That is an absolute must, that we've got to get better there. And our guys are going to have to understand when games are going on, when the cross switches matches start happening. It's understanding you can't buddy run. We're going to have to get turned around quicker, pick up the ball and get to our men. We gave up just a couple wide open shots in the game Saturday, and we can't do that as we continue to go through February.
What jumps out about Florida, a couple of things that they do well?
Certainly. New coach that's done a good job with his roster. A post player that in Castleton that is as effective as any guy in the country. They do a great job of playing through him, and 40% of the game they're going to play with guards, and we'll shoot a high percentage of three-point shots there. Going back to what I just said, transition defense, they're going to look to get it up quick, look to get that early kick out, bust out, and look to shoot the three in transition. So that's going to be really, really important, obviously. Switching, they'll mainly man, but we'll play some zone. But they got some zone presses that they'll run. But they're going to really probably switch it 1 through 4, and which we've seen a lot this year from a lot of different teams. And they're going to play hard. They're going to compete. Extremely well coached. It's hard to win, man. I don't care where you are, what level you're at. It's hard to win basketball games, and we know that it's going to be hard to go to Gainesville, Florida, and get a win. It's hard, but we've got to be locked in and go one day at a time and get better today, tomorrow, and go play.
Where's Mark? BJ at his development right now.
Who?
BJ.
I think he's getting better. I think obviously with playing with an older group of guys that he's had to come in and deal with, we still think he's a big part of this program and certainly a big part of our future. And he's got a great attitude, and guys love him. He's not afraid to compete. It's just, as you know, we're in a situation where it's hard to go beyond probably where we are right now in the rotation with the numbers. But what we love about him is he is truly trying to get better every day.
How does preparation change going from a team that's strictly almost all guards to a team that has a post player like Castleton?
Well, it doesn't change. We've seen that some this year too already, but he certainly is a force and can do a lot of different things. And our post players will have to be on edge because he can do some things, and he can really take a game over. But he plays well with those guards, and our guards are going to have to be able to. It might be a line, but we play four guards. We think we can do that if we have to, and so we'll see how the game. I've said many times, each game takes on its own personality. We'll have to see what personality this one takes on.
Earlier this season, you were kind of frustrated with Zakai taking him out of the starting lineup. How do you think those early hiccups have affected where he is now?
You know, I don't know. Early in the season, I don't know if I'd use the word frustrated. I think you'd probably use the word expectations, probably more than frustrated, because, a guy that plays as hard as Zakai plays, and he's always played hard and competitive, I don't know if you could ever get frustrated with that. You want to see, and what we want to see him do earlier is exactly what he's doing now. He has embraced. He's embraced being more than a guy that can shoot the ball, a guy that can go put pressure on the defense. It's what he's always impacted the game defensively, and he has never not impacted winning. He and Santi have impacted winning impact games, whether they score or not, what they do on the defensive end. And then you put Zakai, what he's doing now, how he's playing more minutes than maybe he should be right now. He's just, it's a great testament to him that he's willing to embrace what we've asked him to do, which means changing what he has to do. But I also think it helps him a lot having a guy like Santi out there. And I think even getting Joe back, guys that are experienced that have been around. And but like I said, he and Santi, they can score the ball, but they're both very unselfish. And the fact is, like I said, they don't have to score. We need them to, but they don't have to. They're going to still fight and do what they need to do to impact winning. And I'm not sure there's a better tandem right now in college basketball in terms of what those guys are doing, and certainly what Z's done as a point guard, taking care of the ball, getting the assist. I'm not sure any point guard in the country has had a better impact on the game than he has.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you, guys.